Welcome to PC Analytics. Today, we're going to dig into the differences between two top budget coolers, the DeepCool Assassin III versus the Thermalright Frost Commander 140. We've got our test bench right here, ready to put these coolers to the test and give you all the information you need to make the perfect choice for your setup. In terms of how these two coolers differ, the Assassin III has black accents and is slightly larger with two 140mm fans, while the Frost Commander features gray accents and has a 120-140mm fan. The Assassin III is slightly harder to install than the Frost Commander, but both are budget-friendly options. However, we know you're here to see how these two coolers perform, so let's dive into it. We've tested both coolers with the AMD 5800X CPU over idle, high, and overclocked temperatures, and have two sets of charts to show you. One that looks at performance normalized by percent speeds, and one that looks at performance normalized by sound. In a first set of charts normalized by percent speeds, we have temperatures on the left represented by the solid line, noise on the right represented by the dashed line, and percent speeds on the bottom. For this graph, lower is always better. At idle, the Assassin III in red has similar cooling performance as the Frost Commander in blue. As we turn up the heat to 105 watts, we can see that the Frost Commander begins to outperform the Assassin III at the higher RPMs. However, this comes at the cost of the Frost Commander being materially louder at the higher fan speeds. As we pump up the heat to overclock levels of 125 watts, we can see that the Frost Commander increases its performance lead. In our second set of charts normalized by sound, we have temperatures on the left, noise on the bottom, with lower being better. At idle, both coolers continue to perform similarly, and as we pump up the heat to 105 watts, both coolers maintain similar cooling performance at comparable noise levels. And when we push the CPU to 125 watts, we can see that both coolers have similar cooling performance where noise is comparable. However, the Frost Commander has headroom for more cooling performance at the higher noise levels. And if you're curious on how the Frost Commander stacks up against another top budget cooler, the Phantom Spirit 120 SE, you should check out this video comparing these two coolers. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this content and found it valuable, I invite you to support us by giving us a thumbs up or hitting that subscribe button. Your support is appreciated.